How can history help us think about the future? My name is Orit Halpern, and I'm the Lighthouse Professor and Chair of Digital Cultures at Technische Universität Dresden. I'm a historian of science, and my research is about big data, smart technologies, and the future of the human and natural worlds. That might not sound very historical to most of you, but I argue that history helps us understand how technology, knowledge, and society change over time and helps us envision what kind of society and what kind of technologies we want in the future. Well, we're standing here in the Deutsche Hygiene Museum. It was built in 1912 by German industrialists. And I'm standing in front of a very famous model of a woman that was used to teach the public about anatomy and medicine. So this whole room is actually about thinking about the human body as a machine. These are all ideas of the norm, or what ideal femininity should have looked like in Germany in the 1920s. These ideas of norms also then fed into eugenics programs that really emerged in the 20s, and later into ideals of the human body and the perfect society as a machine that fueled national socialism and often justified the extermination of groups that were considered undesirable. So of course, this is a perfect example about how both our ideas of science and nature reflect the society and in turn build a society. It shows how ideas of mechanism and how ideas of ourselves are together, and also the possibility, right, that technologies and new forms of knowledge aren't always beneficial, that we have to really think about what are the notions of sexuality, gender, race, and class that are inside them. Then today, I argue we are living in a radically new world, from smart homes to smartphones to smart cities to smart medicine, and I could go on with the list. We live in a world that is ubiquitously penetrated by computing. Artificial intelligence and big data are fundamentally transforming the very constitution of what it is to be human, who constitutes human, and how we understand the relationship between nature and culture. Therefore, it's incumbent for us to really begin thinking about how we're building our technology and to what effect and by whom and for whom. So I'm super excited to be here at TU Dresden and to have the opportunity to work in an institution with so many scientists who are cutting edge in artificial intelligence, biophysics, material science, and so many other fields. And most importantly, I'm really interested in developing centers and research that help us not only diagnose the present, but that help us to envision how to build new worlds and new possibilities that are more equitable, just, and diverse than the ones we have now. So I'm very excited to join in being able to do that here.